One question that I get all the time is, what is the difference between a jointer and a planer, and can I get by with just one or the other if I'm going to do fine woodworking? Stay tuned to find out. Hey, it's Paul with Toolmetrics, and I want to talk a little bit about the differences between a jointer and a planer. And as a way to illustrate this, let's start with the end product in mind. And what we want as a starting point for building our woodworking projects is a board that has a flat face and then an opposing face that's also flat and parallel with the top face, edges that are parallel to one another and square to the top and bottom faces. That's called surface four sides, four sides square, S4S, it's known as in the woodworking community. And so I want to talk through the process of how we arrive at that so you can understand the role of each of these tools in getting us to that point. And first I want to dive in and just talk about each tool independently so you can kind of get a feel for what each one's intended use is. And then I'll walk through that process of milling up perfectly square lumber and the trade-offs and how each machine contributes to that process. All right, let's start with the jointer, because that is in fact where you start. And essentially the jointer has a long flat bed that's going to be one of the surfaces that we're going to use as a reference. And it also has a fence that is perpendicular to the bed. So the operator has an important role in the jointer, more so than in the planer. So with the jointer, the operator is first going to align the board in one position. So this board rocks a little bit, and this is a perfect example of why you need a jointer. This board is rocking, so I, as the operator, am going to hold it into one position and not rock it, not roll through the cut, because now I'm going to continue to have a twisted face on the bottom side if I do that. So I'm going to lock it into one position, pass it through, and make the cut, and that's going to shear one face perfectly flat. Might take a couple passes depending on the severity of the twist, but eventually, if I use the right technique, I'll have a face that's perfectly flat. The next step that the jointer is able to offer is I take that flat face and I'm going to put it up against the fence and I'm going to feed it through the cut. And now after a pass or a couple passes, I've created a board with one perfectly flat face and one edge that is straight and square to the face jointed face. That's where the jointer is relieved of duty after two faces are complete. Why not, you're wondering, flip the board over. The jointer has already proven that it can flatten a face. You have another face to flatten. Why not flip it over and run it through the jointer one more time? The answer to that is yes, it could do it. It could create a flat face, a second flat face on the board. The problem with it is that it has no reference to the other face that you've flattened. And so what you end up with is a board with two flat faces that are not parallel to one another. And in other words, if you measured the board for thickness from side to side and from end to end, it would be different in each measurement direction. So that is not the way you want to start out your woodworking project. And what are the chances, you're wondering, of getting it right, getting them so that they are parallel doing it that way? The answer is virtually zero. You'll never get it correct doing it that way. And that's why you're going to want to run it through the planer. So we'll talk about the planer next. All right, that was the jointer. Now let's talk about the planer. The planer operates quite a bit differently than the jointer. First of all, it has the flat reference surface on the bottom and the cutter head up on top of the board that you're passing through. So now you're taking the board that you just face jointed and edge jointed on the jointer. You take the face that you've jointed and put that down on the planer bed. So now you've got a flat surface up against the flat surface of the planer bed. You start to feed that through. Now the feed rollers grab it. Now they're pulling it through and pressing it downward onto that flat reference surface. That's really the key here. As it's doing that, it's now engaging the cutter head. The cutter head is shearing that wood flat using the bed as the reference surface. So all it's doing is essentially copying the contour of the face that's pressed against the bed. And that contour, hopefully, if you did your face jointing correctly, is flat. So now you've got a board that you're following a flat surface on the bottom. It's creating a flat surface on the top that's parallel with the bottom. And that's the key, and that's what the jointer can't do. So now what it's going to spit out the back of the planer is a board that has a top surface that's flat, a bottom surface that's also flat and parallel, uniform thickness across the width and length of the board. Now you've got three perfect edges, and now all you have to do is take the fourth edge and rip it on the table saw. You're going to use your jointed edge as a reference, put it up against the fence, and run the board through and rip your edge parallel. And now you've got top and bottom that are flat and parallel, side and side that are parallel and square to your faces. You've got an S4S board. And that's the goal that we started out with. So now, with all of that kind of theory in mind, let's do a quick walkthrough and actually mill this board to a perfect S4S. All right, as you recall, the action all starts over at the joiner. Here we're gonna face joint the first face. May take a couple passes, depending on how twisted the board is. Then you're gonna take that flat face, put it up against the jointer fence, and run it through on edge. This will create an edge that's perfectly square to the face that you just face jointed. From there, we move over to the thickness planer. We set that flat face jointed face down on the planer bed and run the board through. The thickness planer uses that flat face as a reference and creates a flat surface on the opposing face that is parallel with the first face, and that parallelism is the key. Now you've got three perfect sides. The next step to get the fourth perfect side is to take the edge that you've jointed, put it against the fence on a table saw, and run it through. All right, there you have it. Hope you found this helpful. Hope it answered some questions for you and hopefully gives you some of the justification that you need to add both a jointer and a planer to your arsenal of tools to help you build some fine furniture. I appreciate you watching this, and I hope you'll subscribe to the Toolmetrics channel for more DIY and woodworking videos coming your way soon. Thanks.